Hey growers, it's Everest with a trivia question for you. How much space do you need for, say, 9 plants? To find the answer, you have to take a length of string, wrap it once around your plants, and there you have it. I'm just hoping you have enough string. No, seriously, forget about plant numbers and think about canopy area instead. Your aim when growing light-loving, fast-growing, heavy-fruiting annuals indoors under grow lights is to produce an even homogeneous canopy. All bud and flower sites should be basking at the same level beneath your grow lights, in that sweet zone where they're receiving maximum intensity without suffering from radiant heat stress. How many plants you use to create this? Well, that's up to you. One giant plant spread out like a candelabra, or lots of little itty bitty plants? For a quick example, earlier this year I grew 4 Baxter bush tomato plants in this 5x5 area, and now I'm growing, wait for it, 16 dwarf chili plants in the same area. Obviously, I expected my individual chili plants to end up a lot smaller than my tomatoes, and this was largely due to my choice of variety, but you can influence the size of your plants using other methods too. Pruning is the most obvious thing you can do to change the size and shape of your plants. Ideally, it should be done early, such as topping your plants after the 3rd or 4th internode during early growth. You're only removing a tiny amount of plant matter and thus wasting only a small amount of invested energy for the plant. However, that simple cut can dramatically alter the shape of your plant in the weeks to come. Next up is bending. As you can see, I've really manipulated my chili plants so that they fill any gaps in the canopy. Some of those main stems are almost horizontal. Pretty extreme, but you get the picture. It's not all about the plants, it's about doing what you need to do to get that all-important canopy. Cleaning up your plants is another important technique. This is basically just removing leaf matter from down below that's not receiving any light anyway. I encourage you to be, well, fairly brutal. If it isn't receiving any light, it's just sapping up resources from your plant needlessly, get rid of it. Cut it out. It'll also help to improve your air circulation. Finally, there's plant stirring. Less frequent irrigations will create drier root zones, which will in turn help to push your plants into generative production. That is, creating buds, flowers, and fruits. It's actually a mild form of plant stress. Incidentally, I misprogrammed my digital timer and my dripper stayed on for, let's just say several hours each day over a period of 2 weeks before I noticed it. But you can see how my chili plants have stayed vegetative for too long, and now they're encroaching upon my grow lights. Eek! I can't raise them anymore, so all I can do is prune, bend, and tuck just like a drag queen. My bad. Now, for those of you growing photoperiodic plants, yes, I'm talking to you, you cheeky little monkeys growing species that simply start flowering in response to the length of the dark cycle. Well, you guys have life relatively easy. Maybe you think that all you have to do is adjust a timer to say 12 hours of darkness, 12 hours light, and your precious little short day plants will start to flower in these conditions, right? Well, okay, yes, but it's worth noting that changing your photo period won't have an immediate effect. No, it can often take 2 to 3 weeks for generative production to really kick in, during which time your plants can grow significantly, a phenomenon known to many indoor growers as stretching. You can minimize or mitigate stretching by tucking lead branches under netting, drier root zones, raising your nighttime temperature so they're closer to your daytime temperatures, and lowering the nitrate content of your nutrient solution. However, my best advice for beginners is to push your plants into flowering a little earlier than you might think. Don't wait for them to fill the space. They'll do that during transition, I promise. Say if one plant's leaves are just touching a neighbor's, it's probably time to induce flowering. Let me repeat, do it sooner than you might think. When the plants still look relatively small, maybe around 18 inches high or less, you can thank me later. Another great tip for beginners is to use containers. Definitely check out the Grow Pro Fabric Breathable Pots. Personally, indoors, I wouldn't go over 5 gallons. You can grow a very large plant in one of these, and good luck lighting it efficiently. Many growers enjoy great success growing in 2 and 3 gallon pots, and are surprised by the size of the plants they can support when irrigated enough. A fast fit tray and a tray stand is a great investment too. These 2x4s are ideal for vegging up young plants under an LEC 315 or T5 fluorescent. A 4x4 tray forms an ideal base for flowering under 1000 watt HPS. Now, to make the most of every last photon, consider housing it all inside a grow tent like the Sun Hut Fortress 150. It measures 4.6 feet by 4.6 feet, and it also allows your plants a bit of breathing space along too, with good support for some soft mesh netting. Okay, time for me to stop talking. Until next time, amigos, this is Everest out.